There are two main components of blood. Plasma is about 55% of the blood volume, and the rest are the formed elements. So erythrocytes are also called red blood cells. They carry oxygen to the cells and then carry some carbon dioxide away from the cells. There's five types of leukocytes. These are white blood cells. So neutrophils, they have a string of pearl nucleus. They're the most abundant white blood cell. They phagocytize pathogens, so they just go along and eat bacteria. Monocytes have this horseshoe-shaped nucleus, and monocytes become macrophages. Eosinophils are effective against parasitic worms, and they have hot pink granules in the cytoplasm. Basophils, these have large denim or dark blue granules. They release histamines, which dilate the veins, and heparin, which acts as an anticoagulant during inflammatory or allergic reactions. And we have lymphocytes. These have this large nucleus, and then they have sky blue cytoplasm, and they attack abnormal or infected cells. Also in the blood, we have thrombocytes, which are called platelets. These are tiny cell fragments, and they're used in blood clotting. So on this model, we can see that an erythrocyte is a biconcave disc. So if I turn it around, you can see it's concave on both sides. A common test question is, what is the abundance of white blood cells in the blood? And a good way to remember that is never for neutrophil, let for lymphocyte, monkeys for monocyte, eosinophils, never let monkeys eat, bananas for basophils. So never let monkeys eat bananas.